Hello, I'm Dr Hazel Lowe, a plasma physicist working on fusion plasma diagnostics at Tokamak Energy in the UK. It's Friday, the 19th of February, 2021, and this is your fusion news update. 1. Lithium could help control extreme heat in future fusion facilities. 2. Trailblazing Lancaster hoping to be home to the planet's first ever nuclear fusion plant, and other local stories. 3. Activating relativistic effects of intense laser light in plasma for nuclear fusion. 4. Empowered by fusion, A systems work on nuclear fusion. And I have a couple of bonus items for you at the end. 1. Lithium could help control extreme heat in future fusion facilities. Researchers from the Princeton Plasma Physics Laboratory have been investigating how to control and reduce the heating of plasma-facing components in the diverter region of a fusion reactor device. The diverter is located in the outer part of a magnetically confined fusion plasma and serves to remove impurities and heat from the plasma core. However, plasma instabilities can cause sudden bursts of heat to be created in the diverter plasma, which have the potential to cause serious damage to components closest to the plasma. In order to prevent any sudden excess heat loads from damaging the plasma vessel, Masayuki Ono and Roger Rahman from PPPL have proposed the use of an electromagnetic particle injector to fire a lithium pellet into the diverter plasma. The lithium would melt and radiate heat away, meaning that less heat would hit the diverter walls. The idea is to inject light impurities such as lithium, boron or beryllium into the diverter region so as to radiate away much of the energy, Ono explained. The trick will be to go in quickly enough to protect the diverter with very little radiation affecting the plasma core. You don't want to inject too much impurity material, just enough to do the job. 2. Trailblazing Lancaster hoping to be home to the planet's first ever nuclear fusion plant, and other local stories. Several local papers in the UK have articles about how their region plans to make a bid to host STEP, the spherical tokamak for energy production. On the 19th of December 2020, Fusion News had a story about how the UK Atomic Energy Authority had launched a search for a suitable site for the fusion pilot plant. Nominations for bids close on the 31st of March. So far, the UK government has committed £222 million to the STEP project, which aims to build on the UK's global leadership in fusion, to deliver a prototype fusion machine and demonstrate the commercial viability of fusion. Mayor of the West of England, Tim Bowles, said, "I want to make our region the international hub for safe, clean fusion technology. Securing the STEP project here will bring more jobs of the future to our region, create new business opportunities, and secure our existing advanced manufacturing supply chains for the long term. It really is an exciting prospect." 3. Activating relativistic effects of intense laser light in plasma for nuclear fusion. A new variant of the fast ignition scheme of inertial confinement fusion has been proposed by researchers from the Institute of Laser Engineering at Osaka University. In fast ignition inertial confinement fusion, a pellet of fusion fuel is compressed by an array of long pulse laser beams and then heated by the high energy electron beam generated by irradiation with a short pulse laser. The degree of heating achieved is determined by the proportion of energy from the short pulse beam that is transferred to the fast electrons and subsequently to the compressed fuel pellet's core. The team at Osaka University have used a double-pulsed, ultra-intense laser scheme instead. A plasma channel created by the first laser pulse allows the second pulse to propagate further into the fuel and therefore increase the proportion of fast electrons able to reach the core and cause heating. The lead author of the study, Tao Gong, explains that by utilizing the relativistic behavior of the high-intensity laser, the energy can be reliably delivered to the fuel in the imploded plasma aiming the ignition. 4. Empowered by fusion. Nuclear Engineering International reports on engineering company A Systems' involvement in fusion projects around the world, including the China Fusion Energy Test Reactor, UK AEA's Engineering Design Services Framework, and the International Thermonuclear Reactor under construction in France. For the ITER project, A System is responsible for the diverter remote handling system, which will allow parts of the diverter to be removed and replaced without requiring invasive manned access to the vessel interior. They are also involved in safety regulation and licensing for various international fusion projects, as well as the UK's spherical tokamak for energy production project, which aims to build a viable fusion power plant by 2040. And now moving on to our bonus stories. In this article, the Institute of Engineering and Technology reflects on the benefits arising from the ITER project, other than the obvious goal of demonstrating that fusion power is commercially viable. They state that since 2008, the supply chain for ITER has supported 29,500 jobs, with investment in ITER having a knock-on positive effect on the European economy. US news outlet CNBC reports on Brandon Sorbaum's journey from being rejected for PhD positions researching nuclear fusion to co-founding Commonwealth Fusion Systems as their chief scientific officer. If you are a regular viewer here on the Fusion News Channel, you will know that Commonwealth Fusion Systems are working on developing high-temperature superconducting magnet technology to incorporate into the next generation of tokamaks. Find out more about their approach by clicking the link below. Finally, Physics World has an article on green technology and growth, looking at the UK government's 10-point plan for a green industrial revolution, and outlining why it is a vision we can believe in. Of course, it mentions fusion and some of the UK private fusion companies like First Light Fusion and Tokamak Energy. That's all for Fusion News this week. Please like and subscribe for more Fusion News and check out the links in the YouTube description if you want further information.